Groundwater is life. Groundwater is 98% of the available fresh water we have on the planet. This is the water that we use for drinking, for growing food, and sustaining the ecosystems around us. The people that are most vulnerable to climate change are those living in sub-Saharan Africa. This video will give you, in their own words, how the Climate Justice Project, funded by the Scottish Government, has actually helped their lives and made them more resilient to climate change.
You cannot talk of sanitation without water. They complement each other. After our communities became ODF, what was lacking now was water to complement the hygiene part. And this project helped us to have water through boreholes that were drilled in 2012. And right now they're able to access water, not only just for sanitation but for drinking.
Before this borehole was drilled with support from Climate Justice Fund, we used to wake up very early. But now, since we have our own water point, we can decide to go to the water point at any point during the day. We are able now to spend more time with our families. I don't have to wake up very early in the morning, so at least I'm able to sleep, and our lives are much better now than before.
This project has been able to reduce waterborne related diseases in Chapananga. This year, with the floods that happened, there was cholera in a number of districts, including Chikwawa. But in this area where Climate Justice funded project was being implemented, there was no cholera.
For the past 5 years, when we started implementing the CGF project, we started looking at the planning at the local level and going upwards, so that the benefits out of the Lulo community-based integrated water resource management project should inform the policies. For example, if you take it 2013-2014, under the charity water, we drilled about 120 boreholes. Out of those, we have seen that almost more than half in the 2013-2014, they have adopted the permaculture practice. In the 2014-2015, each and every water point that we are drilling, we drill 8 this year and rehabilitate 11. Each and every water point has adopted the permaculture practice. The idea is to make sure that we don't lose any drop of water out of the water point.
Through this project, we were told to be able to take care of our own water point. So we have three ways of making sure that we are able to maintain and make sure that our water point is operational throughout. Firstly, we raise money through household collections, and also through the permaculture garden by selling the crops that we grow in the permaculture garden. The last part is where we are using that money that we've collected and establish a village saving and banking account where we loan out money to households. In return, when they give us back, we use that money for repairs and maintenance of our water point.
We also noticed that there is water which is just flowing out, being wasted. And we agreed as a community that let's make use of the water that is being wasted. We can convert this wasted water into money. So far, we have grown three types of crops in this garden. We have grown maize, rice, and now it's potatoes.
I think there are still other water point committees that are still not doing well on permaculture. They may need some more agricultural expertise on how best they can go about choosing the right crop for their gardens, maybe depending on the soil type.
The issues to do with water are cross-cutting, that they're affecting even agriculture, forestry. So the CJF has harnessed all these line ministries to incorporate them and synergize in efforts to manage water as a resource, as well as water as used by households or communities.
Most people now, depending on the boreholes for domestic water supply. We may have a large number of boreholes, but if we are not sure whether these boreholes are effectively used or not, then we just talk about having many boreholes, but without actually providing the service.
The students from the University of Strathclyde have helped us a lot to understand how salinity is impacting our communities and how it can be minimized. We have learned through proper drilling procedures how we can avoid aquifers that are affected with salinity. So that is a major contribution, and also, I should say, a breakthrough as part of curbing out the salinity issue here in Chikwawa.
If we have a borehole that is not being used, it's been abandoned because it is salty, then this innovation, this initiative comes and then identify where the salt is originating and be able to treat that. Most of the salty boreholes turn fresh and everybody else becomes happy again. We increase the number of useful boreholes than before.
Yes, there have been studies, academic ones, by professors from Chancellor College, Polytechnic, on groundwater here in Chikwawa, but it didn't really get into us as planners, programmers, that we can use that information practically on the ground. The researches, the studies that have been conducted, we are able to understand and use them right there and then in our own communities.
My passion and what I would like to see is that what is happening in Chikwawa, what has happened in Chapananga, to go beyond Chapananga, to go beyond Chikwawa. What we've started is a great work, and it must extend to other places within Malawi.
The work is not done. There's a lot more to do. We don't know yet how sustainable our project really is, and that's where we have to put a lot more effort into. And then once we know that, then we can carry on our knowledge to other areas, or even estimate the impact of wash projects over the whole of the African continent.
I would want what we've done, the mapping work that we're doing, the scientific studies that we're doing with some of the students from Strathclyde, that's something that needs to be replicated and sustained over time so that we have a better understanding of the groundwater. That's the key, that's the real issue. For me, especially looking at the importance of data, that to me has been the biggest success and the biggest positive outcome of this project. It's actually helped us as an organization plan better, to implement our work better, and to really start asking the hard questions that will be important, especially going forward as we're talking about the Sustainable Development Goals post 2015. It has given us the evidence to actually start asking those questions, and that's something I thank the Scottish Government for.
As water for people, we believe, and this is our vision, we want to see everyone have access to safe water and sanitation forever.